Student, in previous lecture we studied the introduction of bacteria and what are the different sizes and shape of bacteria. Now in this session or in this lecture we are going to see the bacterial cell structure, what is the morphological structure of bacteria. So as we can see in this figure, the bacterial cell consists of different parts. Okay. So the outermost layer of the bacteria, it is called as a glycocalyx, or sometimes it is called as capsule. Then there is a cell wall, then it contains cytoplasmic membrane, then outer membrane. Some bacteria contains flagella, some may not contain flagella. Here is the flagella, then the periplasm, mesosomes, fimbri, pili. Inside the cells it contains chromosomes, then polysomes, the capsule, it is the outermost layer. Here you can see the capsule, and some inclusion bodies are present inside the cell. If we study the bacterial cell properly, we can say that the bacterial cell or the structure of bacteria, it is divided into three parts. The structure which are present outside the cell wall, then second one, cell wall itself, and third, the structure which are present inside the cell. Okay, so I think all of you got it. The first, the structure outside the cell wall. Second, cell wall itself, and third, inside. Okay, so here we can see this is the structure, this is the structure which are present outside the cell wall. The blue color you can see the cell wall, and the yellow color region are whatever the things which are comes from this region, inside this region, it is inside the cell wall. Okay, so let us see which are the structure which are present inside the cell wall and which are the structure which are present outside the cell. So the capsule, here we can see the capsule which is present outside the cell wall. The outermost layer of the bacterial cell is the capsule. Okay, then after that, flagella. Here we can see the flagella, hair like structure which is outside the cell wall. They are also present outside the cell wall. Fimbri, here the hair like appendages present, they are also present outside the cell wall. And pili. Okay, then after the capsule you can see the blue color margin, this is called as cell wall. And beneath the cell wall there is plasma membrane, ribosomes, then nuclear materials, plasmids, inclusions, ribosomes, all they are present inside the cell wall. Now let us study one by one. The outermost layer, that is glycocalyx. Okay, so glycocalyx, it is a sugar coat, and most of the bacteria secretes a substance, it is called as glycocalyx, and it is in general terms used for the substance that surrounds the cell, means it forms the coat outside the cell. It is formed by external to the cell wall. The chemical composition varies with the species, means from the species to species the chemical composition of glycocalyx varies. It is a viscous, sticky and gelatinous composed of polysaccharides and peptides. It is made up of polysaccharides and peptides. It is made up inside the cell and secreted outside the cell wall. Means it is secreted outside the cell wall. It is synthesized inside the cell wall and it is secreted outside the cell. When it is firmly attached to the cell wall, it is called as capsule. And when it is loosely bound, it is called as slime layer. In next slide, you can easily distinguish. Here you can see the difference between slime layer and capsule. You can see here the glycocalyx. It is loosely bound. That's why it is called as slime layer. In this figure, you can see it is firmly attached. That's why they are called as capsule. In some bacteria, capsules are important in pathogenesis. That's why the capsulated bacteria are most virulent or most pathogenic than non-capsulated bacteria or uncapsulated bacteria. For example, only encapsulated Bacillus anthracis can cause anthrax disease, and Streptococcus pneumoniae can cause pneumonia. A glycocalyx is made up of sugar, is called as extracellular polysaccharides. Okay, it helps bacteria to survive. Okay, major functions of glycocalyx, it attaches the host cell. It attaches the bacteria to the host cell. Means attachment to the host cell is done by capsules or glycocalyx. It is also a source of nutrition. It prevent the dehydration of bacteria. It can be easily escape out of host of the human system. So capsules protect the bacteria to escape out the host immune system.